Hey everyone, you're watching Crow at Crow and the Vet, and thanks for tuning in today. Today's video, I'm going to be explaining to you guys a long-term review of the C7Z06. Now, I had this car for a little over 3 years now, and I wanted to be quite honest with you and give you guys a rundown of how this vehicle has treated me, what kind of maintenance costs I've gone through with the vehicle, what my insurance costs are, and whatnot. So basically, let's go ahead and get right into it. Getting right in, this is my C7Z06. It is wrapped in satin frozen gold chrome. I had the wrap on for about 3 years now, and to be honest, it just looks absolutely amazing. It was white originally underneath the wrap, but I decided to give it a little bit of extra like oomph to it. So vinyl wrapping this car with the black accents, in my opinion, just looks stunning. This thing is equipped with the 3LZ package. It has a carbon fiber roof. And what I did to this vehicle is also PPF the front bumper. And right here, I added black accents along the bumper. So it kind of gives it like a double splitter looking layout. So one thing I'm going to mention about buying this vehicle is if you guys are in the market, make sure you either get a 2LZ or a 3LZ package. The reason I say that is you want to have the front cameras on here. The front camera will really help you avoid like chipping your splitter or like scraping it. So definitely don't settle for like a 1LZ. You guys have to go 2LZ or 3LZ. Let's talk about insurance on a C7Z06. I am 25 years old, and to insure this car, it costs about $120 a month, which is really cheap. You guys would think it's like several hundred dollars, but that's not the case. And when I looked into it, the reason being is majority of the owners who own Corvettes are like in their 50s and 60s. Obviously with the C8 coming out, it changed the demographic. But when I spoke to my insurance agent, she basically said that these cars are not that crashed often, ironically. So that's why insurance is pretty cheap. But on another note, I have no tickets on my record, no accidents at fault. So, you know, for being 25 and not having accidents, my insurance in general is cheap. But I owned a 370Z Nismo before this car. And ironically, that was $200 a month to insure. So a lot more than this, you can imagine, which made no sense considering that car was a lot slower. So let's talk about MPG in this car. It is pretty bad, you can imagine. I get about 14 miles per gallon on average with this car. So it's not the best thing in the world, but you know what? It's miles per gallon. Every sip of gas, every cost to operate this car is 100% worth it. You know, in a way, I personally consider it like a domestic supercar. A lot of people say the Z06s are not a supercar, but in my heart and in my eyes, they are. I mean, look at the styling. It's beautiful. It's perfect. Like I said, this car gets a lot of attention, and it's just like you cannot beat the dollar value for this vehicle. Right now, they're going for about $75,000, $80,000 in the market for a manual transmission one, and I believe truly these are just going to keep going up and up. And believe it or not, guys, I did drive the C8 Z51. And if you're wondering how that compares to this car, I'm going to tell you straight up, this is a completely different car than the C8. This car is very scary. This car gives you adrenaline. You know, like, you wake up in the morning, you go in your garage, you're going out on a drive. You want to have that adrenaline, that heart racing moment driving this car, banging through every gear. And this is what this car provides. The C8, on the other hand, it's more of just like a grand tour. Basically, it just drives for you, you know, it's an automatic transmission. It's very comfortable and nice, don't get me wrong, it's a badass vehicle. But this Z06 is a true driver's car and a lot cheaper than a C8 considering all the markups. So again, if you're gonna buy this car, you will make zero mistakes. One good thing about this car is the trunk space. It's huge. So if you go ahead and open it up, you got some look in here. It's massive. I do all my Costco runs in here. You can fit a lot of groceries, a lot of duffel bags if you're traveling. I did take this on a long road trip up to Lake Tahoe, which was about 4 hours away from where I live, and it worked great. I had no issues when it came to storage. The only major maintenance costs on this car, though, I would have to say is the tires. So this car came with the Michelin Pilot Sport Cup 2s, and let me tell you, they do not last long. I don't recommend these tires for daily driving because you only get about 12, 15,000 miles on them. But hey, it works. When it's hot outside, it grips like crazy. Funny enough with these tires, one of them actually popped on me on a dirt road when I was driving with my brother. We were coming to a stoplight. I made a right turn and boom, it just like blew up. And there was literally, you can see the the wire sticking out, so they had to replace that. Because these are run flats, when they did pop, I was able to drive safely to a tire shop and they were able to order me a new tire and install it, which is cool. So with run flats, they're kind of nice in that regard. You don't have to worry about like breaking down on the side of the road and having to tow your car home if it's like a tire issue. In my personal opinion, what I love about this car too is the rear. It is gorgeous. It is very wide, especially with the 325s in the back. It looks a lot nicer than the C8. With the C8, it just kind of looks like it's all over the place. I'm not a fan of the taillights. With the C7 though, it just has a very, very menacing look to it, especially from the back. And then this little duckbill wing, gorgeous. You just can't go wrong with this car. There's no like ugly angles. Everything is just beautiful. One thing I love about this car too is the exhaust note. It sounds crazy good. Check it out. Coming right into the cabin, you guys can see it is equipped with the 7-speed manual transmission. And honestly, this transmission is the way to go. You have to get this car in manual. The automatic is not really that good. It's kind of like a slush box. So if you can drive manual, I highly recommend you guys get this car in manual. It's not the nicest interior around. The C8 is a lot nicer, but you know what? It's not bad either. I do like the way it looks. When I first got the car, I really wanted the red and black interior, but that was impossible to find. Although, you can't go wrong with this. And you can see there's the carbon fiber trim on here. Here you have your cup holders, so if you press it open. One thing I don't like is this little cup holder piece. So it is adjustable and movable. I kind of wish they had like a fixed position. So, I don't know. It works, but sometimes it gets annoying if you have like Starbucks cups or whatever, it will wiggle around. So just keep that in mind. And here you got a little bit of space. There's a little USB here, so I normally charge my phone. It does have CarPlay, however it's not wireless, at least on my model year, the 2016. It's wired CarPlay, but it works well. So one thing I did do to this vehicle is installed a MGM short shifter on my car. I highly recommend you guys get the MGM short shifter. It makes the throws a lot shorter, it's a lot better to daily drive with, and it just makes driving in general a breeze. And the cool thing about it, it sounds like a bolt action rifle. So when you clutch in, listen, it's just so satisfying. So I highly recommend you guys get it. I'll leave a link in the description below. If you guys are planning on getting the manual, this is a must. Another awesome thing about the Z06 is a little screen button right here. So you press it down, you can go ahead and store items in here. You have a little USB port so you can charge devices. And pretty much you can keep it hidden in here. And if you're valeting your car, you can even lock the screen so no one can open it without a PIN code. Another thing I want to mention is this car did have a recall. Basically, the fuel tank had a leak, so you can smell fuel early in the morning when you cold start the car and you reverse out of the driveway. Chevrolet did work with me wonderfully. They did fix the problem, free of charge, obviously. I don't have a warranty in this car anymore, so if you're worried about owning this car out of warranty, you should be okay. I mean, the parts are cheap. It's very easy to work on. It's extremely reliable. If something does go wrong, chances are you're not going to be paying hundreds and hundreds of dollars on a part like other manufacturers charge. So you don't have to really worry about maintenance costs. Obviously, always set money aside. But if you're thinking this is an extremely like expensive car to maintain, that's not the case. Oil and filter runs me like 40, 50 bucks. I do it myself. The air cabin filter and all that crap, it's very cheap and easy to replace. You can just follow a few YouTube videos. So yeah guys, I'm gonna take you on a POV drive soon so you guys can kind of get a feel of what it's like to drive, or a visual feel I should say. One thing too I want to mention is a lot of people think these cars overheat on the track, and that's not the case, at least for me. With the manual transmissions, you don't have to worry about overheating, but I did hear of cases where people with the automatic transmissions, after a few laps, they start to overheat. So I don't know, I had no issues with overheating. And if you're buying this car, most likely you're going to get the manual and you're going to get a pre-purchase inspection, make sure everything's fine. Let's go ahead and give this car a startup. All right. So, this vehicle has currently 2,700 miles on the odometer, as you can see right here. I bought this car when it had 2,700 miles, so I put a lot of miles on this car. And knock on wood, I had no issues with the vehicle.
It's treating me wonderfully. I do daily drive it every single day. I'm over here in California, so I don't really have to worry about snow. This car is very daily friendly.
All right, guys, so here we are doing a POV of the C7Z06. Gonna show you guys how much power this thing has and how scary it can actually get. We are in a public road, so I don't want to get too crazy when there's cars around. I'm gonna go approach a highway and just do a little bit of a throttle on ramp for you guys. You can see how easy it is to shift the car with the short shifter. Just makes it a breeze. On the streets, I'm usually always in second or third gear. You never ever have to go past third gear. Unless you want to be conservative about your mileage. Or gas, I should say. We do have multiple modes. So right now we're in sport mode. You can hear the exhaust. If we switch that over to touring mode, it'll soften up the suspension and it'll quiet the exhaust. So now if we do a downshift, it's quiet. You have these rev matching paddles behind here. People do think this shifts for you. No, it doesn't. This is just to turn on the auto rev match feature. So you can tell right here, there's a green 2. That's the gear I'm in. So first gear, if you click rev match, it'll turn white. Active rev match off. And then active rev match is back on. Me personally, I always keep the auto rev match on. It just, you can never shift better than the computer, or downshift, I should say. As long as you don't smash on a throttle with cold tires, you won't really have a big issue. In the colder climate, especially in the rain, this car can be extremely dangerous. So be very careful and be responsible on how much throttle response you give in this car. Going to be approaching an on-ramp. Give you guys a little taste of the Z06 power. With its 650 horsepower and torque. Here we go. Wow. I'm telling you, this never gets old. There's a lot of traffic out, so I have to be very careful. I can't drive reckless, but you guys get the idea. This is just too much power for the street. Way too much. It's unusable. Fourth to third downshift. Already hitting almost 90. This is crazy. Just sounds absolutely brutal. This car is vicious. It screams like, get the hell out of my way. Absolutely amazing. We do have a good amount of road noise from the tires, so it's not the quietest cabin. It's pretty damn loud. Like I said, it's too much power on the street. I can't really show you guys the full potential of this car. No one can. Even on a racetrack, you're gonna struggle to get all the power out. It's just too damn brutal. The torque is just insane, and this is why I love supercharged vehicles. Supercharged V8s, they just pull and pull and pull. No turbo lag, none of that nonsense. Me personally, I just prefer supercharged cars. I also did own a Mark V Supra. I owned it for about 11 months, but I sold it. That was a really good car too, but this car is just a whole nother level. There you guys have it. Short little POV of what it's like to drive this car. I'm just now getting ready to have my dinner. Haven't ate all day, so yeah, guys.
Let's do one more exterior walk around in the car. And that's it for today's video. Thanks for tuning in. I do have more content coming up in the future, like how much did it cost to wrap this car, how well has it held up in the past 3 years, and a lot more videos coming soon. If you enjoyed the video, like and subscribe below, and I'll see you guys next time.